Let's go to Mike in Maryland, because you can bring up whatever's on your mind. Mike, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, thanks for taking my call. Sure. I really enjoy listening to y'all show when I have the chance.
Appreciate it. Go
ahead. My voice is starting to change. Oh, that's good.
Sorry. Right on time, too.
At any rate.
Go ahead.
Okay. No, this is, you know, serious stuff here. I'm a news junkie and a talk show addict, okay? That's my
hobby. I'm sorry.
I know. Maybe there's a 12-step group that can help me here. But at any rate, though, I want to talk about the situation with the ISIL situation.
Sure.
In Syria and Iraq, and I've been following this fairly closely, and I'm sure you all have heard that, you know, that Assad is this evil, corrupt dictator that has to be taken out, that I'm sure you know that this, or probably know that the civil war is not really a civil war. These are hired cutthroat mercenaries, al-Qaeda mercenaries, that are being backed and trained by the CIA and Gulf State money.
I'm confused as to what's going on here, and I want you to make it clear for me here in a moment. So hang on, Mike. We'll bring you back. I'm not sure what he's getting at. Where is Al-Qaeda involved in
this?
I thought we were talking about ISIS.
ISIL is...
They were Al-Qaeda in Iraq.
Yeah.
And then they turned into different other things.
Okay. More coming up here.
Just because he has the microphone doesn't make him
informed. You take control here. This is Free Talk Live. Let's go back to Mike. He's in Maryland. I was trying to make a point about ISIS, and I have to admit I was kind of confused. You were talking about Al-Qaeda. Didn't Al-Qaeda rebrand as ISIS?
Yes, it was. It's more or less rebranded into ISIS. Now, on the other hand, see, because I wanted to preface what I was going to say about the initial reason why I called in. Now, it was rebranded. So now we're supposed to bomb ISIS in Syria, because they're using that as a hideout, but yet it's basically the same people that were attacking Assad. So this is, you know, this is the seemingly schizophrenic foreign policy that we have. But I wanted to bring to your attention a huge meeting attended by 80,000 people and 600 prominent politicians from the West and America, and this could be researched easily enough. This is from VoltaireNet.org. And now InfoWars, Alex Jones had an article on it, too. It's the International Meeting for ISIL, ISIL, in France. You can Google this easily, and a bunch of hits will come up. And this is basically the Western nations showing support for ISIL. And it was attended by General Shelton, former chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, General William Casey, former commanding general of Iraqi Freedom, Newt Gingrich, Joseph
okay,
Lieberman.
You're dropping a lot of names. What's the point you're trying to make?
Well, the point I'm trying to make is we caught them red-handed, the American government and the West.
Who caught who red-handed?
Our government and the Western governments supporting the ISIS terrorist by attending this ISIL meeting, which is the
So just to be clear, hold on. What you're saying is the United States is both supporting and fighting ISIS or ISIL?
Yes.
Well, we're supporting and training and financing them, and now supposedly we're going to bomb ISIS, but these quite possibly are either rogue elements of ISIS that have strayed off the reservation, or if we bomb ISIS in Syria, we're going to use that as an excuse to attack Assad's forces.
Well,
but this whole meeting of ISIL, which is the political arm of ISIS, was attended by tens of thousands of people, including many prominent Western and American politicians and Pentagon elites.
Mike, ISIL and ISIS are just they're both the same thing. It's just different names for the same thing. One of them is not the political arm of the other or anything like that.
One thing that's clear to me is that if you bomb people enough time, pretty soon you're not going to know who you have to bomb. And that's really what the problem is here. The United States is now doesn't know who to kill, right? Do we kill Assad? We were supposed to kill Assad last year. Now this year we're supposed to kill ISIS. This is kind of what happened with the World War I situation, where World War I created both Hitler and Stalin. And then they ended up fighting in World War II, and the United States had to pick a side, so they picked the side of the guy who ended up killing millions and millions of his own people against the guy who was going to kill millions and millions of his own people. The difficulty when you start thinking that somehow you're going to solve other people's problems, this is what happens.
Well, the bottom line is the United States is a state sponsor of terrorism worldwide.
Sure, sure. That's absolutely true. And that's, you know, that's not news. It's been like that for many decades. And I'm glad, you know, thanks for bringing this to the table, Mike. Appreciate the call tonight. This certainly is nothing new, right? Because the CIA was involved in al-Qaeda in the past, and, you know, the U.S. government armed Saddam Hussein, and you just go on down the list.
And the U.S. has looked the other way when some Chechen extremists have been doing what they've been doing, because the Chechens are enemies of our enemy, Russia. And there's a lot of Chechens in Syria now who have leadership roles in ISIS.
Right, but the Chechens bombed the Boston Marathon. This is the problem. This is why the Founding Fathers called them entangling alliances. You just stay out of them.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.